factors. So the MSCI changes, which were announced about a month back, come into effect as of today's close. Expect the last 30 minutes to be crucial, because this doesn't affect regular active fund managers, but passive fund managers who got their funds benchmarked to a certain index, MSCI in this case. And any change to the MSCI, these funds, passive funds, will have to make corresponding changes. So what these funds do is, to reduce tracking error, come in the last 30 minutes and effect the changes which MSCI is making to its indices. So just a couple of very simple basic points. Because of these changes, India's weight in the MSCI Emerging Market Index is increasing to 8.93%. That's 20 basis points. It might not seem much, but we're talking about billions of dollars. But 20 basis points more, and the weight now stands at nearly 9% in MSCI EM. Gross sell figures, the net number because of these changes for India is about $424 million, which is that as a result of these changes, Indian stocks will receive about $424 million. And the last point, which is relevant if you're tracking stocks or trading stocks, these are the figures. IOC, REC and ICICI Bank are the three big sort of impacted stocks in a positive way. So IOC gets in about $179 million, REC about $105, ICICI Bank about $218. Ekta, we've discussed the impact of this before as well. You know, typically what would happen is that because the changes are announced a month back, a lot of local participants would buy the stock in anticipation that they'd be able to sell these stocks to the passive fund managers who would want to buy just, you know, 30, 40 minutes before the close today. So it's not as if all this money is coming in today. A lot of the buying has been done, and trades will basically be crossed at high levels by close today.
Okay, well, that's on...